All right, so this is setup of the Wyze Cam Pan. First thing you're gonna do is make sure that you go and install the Wyze app. If you don't, you kinda need it. So I already have it installed, so what we're gonna do is we're going to select the three dots in the upper right-hand corner here, and we're going to say add a product, which might be a little hard to see, so I'll zoom in on that a little bit, add a product. And right there to the right, you see the Cam Pan, and we're going to hit add product. You're gonna select what you want, and here we go, we want the pan. Did you remove the film? Yes, there is a piece of film across the lens there, so you wanna make sure you remove that. And in our case, we're gonna just tap that because we did. So next we need to connect your phone to a 2.4 gigahertz network, and that you have a password ready. Connect camera to power, and then you'll be prompted to push the button down there. Now, currently I do not have my phone connected to 2.4 gigs, so I'm gonna have to do that. All right, so I put it back on the 2.4 gig network that I use for my IoT devices. So we're gonna go ahead and plug this in with the provided cable. Which is just a little tricky to do around the camera, considering the base plate is where you're plugging it into, which makes sense because the top part is going to rotate. Now I did hear some clicking. The pan starts spinning, I'm assuming, to indicate that it's ready, because there is no status light on this like there was on the Wyze Cam V1 or V2. We're gonna click the setup button right down here as prompted there. All right, and then we press the setup button, and when it says ready to connect, we hit next. So here is the 2.4 gig network. We're just gonna hit
ready to connect.
Next, which there is a QR code which you scan, that you scan with your camera. Let's see if I can do this around the actual camera.
Ready to connect. QR code scanned. Please wait.
So I'm tapping, I heard QR code scanned, and we're just gonna put that back there. It's a little tricky to do.
Setup completed.
I felt like the setup on this one was much faster than it was for the version 2. They really streamlined this process compared to what it used to be like. Although, connecting on the app is still, oh, there we go. So we're gonna enter a device name, and we're gonna cheat. Living room. Text to speech. And we're gonna hit okay. And finish setup. So it's successful. So if we come back to my main page, there we go. We've got the Cam Pan, and we'll just click on that to make sure that everything is connected. All right, so there are some firmware updates that need to be done, but hopefully, and we'll actually zoom in on that. You can kind of see my hand moving in the background there, so you know that it is connected. So that was the setup process for the Pan here, and I'm just gonna do the upgrade and everything will be fine. Nice and easy.